Bom dia, amigos!
E boas-vindas, futuras estrelas POT!
E boas-vindas, futuros estrelas POT! Ao se te pego!
What's happening, boys, and welcome to the Pedro Antonio Pereira Gonçalves Episodia, aka Poche. By the way, shout out my boy, Zhao. He let me know that this guy's name is Pedro Gonçalves. His nickname is Poche, so that's what we're going to call him from now on. For 150,000 coins, I think the community is a little bit split. It doesn't have the greatest like ratio in terms of the SBC. It seems to be a little bit conflicted because we're in, like, February. But you want to know what? I say, yo, bin that. Scrap that. I don't care. This is Pedro Gonçalves, the Liga Nos boys, and I know a lot of you guys, for those of you guys that build your Liga Nos squads, it has been absolutely nothing. There's nothing. There's like two informs. There's a right back who's actually looks pretty versatile, and then outside of that, there hasn't been a whole lot of stuff that you could put together if you have a Liga Nos side. This time last year, I feel like we had so many crazy Liga Nos cards, and then now we finally get our first, like, high-rated, really, really solid-looking, and a card that can play right now. Pedro Gonçalves, who is also the top goal scorer in Liga NOS. So it's a fun little card to collect, if for no other reason than that he's a really talented young dude, and he's currently atop the charts in the Liga NOS, and a big reason why Sporting are currently atop the table. But today, boys, we're gonna find out if this card might be worth the 150,000 coin asking price. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Smash like on the video if you support Sporting. Smash like on the video if you think this isn't, like, the craziest card ever, but you're happy that a lower tier, lower league is finally getting a little bit of recognition in the form of Liga NOS. And I gotta say, the Sporting badge looks very cool with the Future Stars color, and maybe it's just something that I can appreciate, but I just like how all the colors blend. And yeah, let's just dive right into the players with you. So he's 5'8", he's got a name that has four parts: Pedro Antonio Pereira Gonçalves, aka Poche, that's his nickname. Again, João, thank you very much. Four star. On the face stats, he looks pretty damn good, and then you go into the stats, and they're actually pretty damn good. 91 acceleration goes up to 99, acceleration, 89 sprint speed goes up to 99, so with the Hunter, he's 99-99, so that, I mean, like, you can't make an argument that he's not fast enough. Shooting goes over, attacking positioning goes over 90, finishing goes up to 94, shot power goes up to 93, long shots 90, which is kind of smexy. Volleys, penalties go up with the Hunter, respectively. Passing stats are passable for a right winger. I mean, if you're playing him at a right winger, as a right winger, I think Catalyst might be the play there. You want to get that crossing up. You want to get probably the long passing up as well. But we're going to be playing him, which is striker. I'm fine with him having the 85 vision and then short passing 84 and then curve 83. That's decent. And then dribbling stats, I don't think you really even need to touch them. 86 composure, very solid. 89 agility, 88 balance, 87 ball control, and then the all-important 86 stamina. And has a little bit of strength and aggression to boot. So not a bad-looking card. And I must say, if you're running him as a right winger or a right mid, maybe slap something that gets his defensive stats jacked off, because you can get all those over 70. Defensive awareness can go over 70. Interceptions can go over 70 with the shadow. He's got flair, and outside of that, nothing too crazy to write home about. I've kind of been flirting with this idea that, you know, this year's 150K is maybe last year's 100K, if that makes sense. So I don't know, maybe just something to think about. So we're running with the full Portuguese side. Had to. Ronaldo started off at Sporting. Poche is at Sporting doing absolute bits. We have obviously Bruno Fernandes. We've got ourselves the João Felix. We got Renato Sanche. We've got Diego Dalot. We've got Jose Font, Ruben Dias, João Cancelo, and we've also got Anthony Lopez in net. So the full Portuguese squad. I wish there was a center back. There's a right back in Liga NOS that we could have used here, but I'd much rather just use Ruben Dias. This sort of SBC is, you can get a little bit creative with your squad, and that's exactly what we're taking the opportunity to do today, is just put together a full Portuguese squad, try to have a little bit of fun in FIFA, even though the new patch makes it feel like you have 15-pound weights in your player's boots. So he's got Martial, he's got KDB. Finished 21-8 in Weekend League on the RTG. If you guys missed it, did that on stream yesterday. Was playing, felt like I was playing horribly, but somehow we strung together a bunch of wins. We ended up going, I think, what was it, 14 and something on the night. We only lost four games, so it was kind of crazy. But anyway, match number one with this Poche. Let's see what he's got. Again, what is it, 14 goals in Liga NOS? And he's hella young too, that's super impressive. See what the pace looks like. Verba.
Another Verba.
So oh my god!
Another body feint, and then Bruno. Bruno, how are you missing that?
Salvador entrada para quedarse con ella. Se viene la presión del rival, ojo. Linda pelea.
Renato Saj. Dude, even his 82 card is so crazy. Alright, we got ourselves a cheeky Nani. Gonzalo. Yeah, Poche. Look at him run. Go Verba. Go on, lad.
Ahí está cerca, puede ser, ahí está.
Se cruzó
Kanté. João Félix. Ahí lo tiene, pase corto, lindo juego, qué bien, nada de pelotazo.
González.
Okay, Pedro Gonzalez. He's apparently, apparently the Berba spin is a popular dance to do in Portuguese culture, and he's absolutely able to execute it near perfectly. No defender has been able to take the ball off. He's a technically proficient, agile midfielder, is how he's described. So I completely forgot to mention the fact that he comes as a center mid guard as well. I think most people are probably doing the right winger version.
João Félix. Nani.
Gotta have that. Poche, we gotta have that, my man. Renato Sanche, he does it all. Renato Sanche literally does it all. Nah. Jose Font. That's the risk that you take running a Portuguese backline.
Cristiano Ronaldo. Recibe Cristiano. Che buona voce mettete.
Gonçalves.
Oof. Poche, come on, bro. We gotta have that, my man. The build-up play between the exporting players, the past and present.
Gonçalves.
Don't do it to me.
Just stop!
Ah, you gotta be kidding me, man!
João Félix.
What the hell did I
do? Referee, the... Poche is app... Dude, he's got some... He's got some agility on him, dude. Bruno Fernandes, what is Poche... Poche Gonzalez? We gotta give it to Poche. Come on. Hey, you wanna know what? You know who we're gonna give it to? We're gonna give it to Ronaldo. How's Ronaldo? How are they gonna give him Ronaldo 75 pence? Right up the middle. Blast that. Got him.
Sigue manejando la pelota pegadita al pie. Cuidado que puede terminar en gol.
You wanna know what?
Fernández quiere controlar.
This Poche SBC, this Pedro Gonzalez Epi SBC was worth doing if for no other reason than reuniting me with that Nani card and giving me a reason to use this card for the first time in FIFA 21.
Ambicioso el traslado para meter ese balón entre líneas.
Gol!
Esta puede ser buena. Me parece que tengo que retractarlo.
Este puede ser buena.
Another, wait, another pen? Wait, was that another pen? All right, so this time, I'm going to get inside his head. He thought I was going to go middle, but he went right the last time, so I thought I would go right this time.
Nani es un genio pasando la pelota. Qué buen servicio, lo deja de cara gol. Ojo, que tiene...
Come on, Nani.
Go!
You want to know what? I probably could have kept running with Pedro.
Ojo que la puede cruzar. Ahí va Cristiano. Bruno Fernández quiere controlar. Nani.
Nani.
Oh my gosh! Stop!
Regresa esta pelota en algún momento al Boro. Ahí va Cristiano. Nani.
Gonçalves.
Okay, Poche sent an absolute Pastéis Donata rocket blast into the back of the net, dude. Go on, Poche. Jeez. You don't see it on the stat line, but the man of the match was 8.4. 8.4 for Poche. Gets himself a goal, gets himself an assist. But the reason Ronaldo has two goals is because of Poche. And we get ourselves a 4-3 win. Look at the absolute thunderstrike blast. Jeez.
Arquero, vaya valentía para llegar a quedarse con la pelota.
La verdad, a veces hasta te emociona estas jugadas.
La mandó la defensa.
Whoa! That was RB Square. Look at the pass from Ronaldo. The pass from Ronaldo to Poch. Jeez.
Gonzalo Guedes.
And Tweez fits it in there to the 46. Gonna be just shy of the sticks.
Was very interesting.
I think I'm gonna get out of the game. I think I'm gonna get out of this game right now.
He was.
What is going on?
Okay. All right, Pedro Gonzalez. I mean, this is legitimately a piece of art. That guy right there is every Liganos. That guy right there is every Liganos supporter that's happy that they finally got an SBC. Yes. Here's another one from Poch. Nice little Berba spin, left-hand log stick dribble, and then pop in the top left-hand corner of the net. But anyway, my dudes, that's going to do it for the Episodia. 3 games played, 6 goal contributions, and like I said, is it the craziest card in the game? No, but is it a really good card? I think it's a really, really good. I think it's a good card. I'm not going to give it a 4. I'll give it a 3.5 out of 5 in terms of the Infinity Gauntlet value. I think, you know, there are a bunch of, you know, you got the Bernardo Silva, you got the Ronaldo. And it's not just about a Portuguese player if you're running a Liganos side, and if you're a Liganos supporter, specifically if you're a Sporting or Liganos supporter, this card is gonna be attractive to you. In terms of on-the-pitch performance, I gotta give him a 4 out of 5. Silky as all hell, was single-handedly responsible for 3 pens that we were able to convert with Ronaldo because of how silky is inside the box. And then has some nice, really, really nice finishing capabilities, and showcased a little bit of that top-end speed if you put the Hunter Kemp style on him, which obviously brings him up to 99.99. So again, like I said, is it the craziest card in the game? No, but for about 150,000 coins, I think it's a solid card. You're going to need to run the Hunter on him if you want him to be a striker. I'd maybe say Catalyst or maybe even an Engine if you want to use him as a winger. But like I said, boys, hey, this one's for the Liganos boys. This is why I did the Episodia. A lot of you guys, you know, there's like 3 special cards in Liga NOS, so we had to showcase one of them, and arguably the best one, easily the best Liga NOS special card in FIFA 21. But that's going to do it for the Episodia, boys. Smash like if you guys did enjoy. Hit that subscribe button if you guys are new to the channel. Going to be streaming. Going to probably be doing the Tonali objective tonight on stream, so if you guys want to pop by for that, link is in the description below. And yeah, I will catch you guys for another upload tomorrow. Till next time, my bros. Tschüss. Later. Ade.